So yeah, thank you. Thank you very much for inviting me to present here my SharePoint hackathon. I'm very honored with this. I participated in the hackathon with a very simple entry, but let's see what happened. First, some information about me. My name is Michael Greth. I'm here from Berlin, Germany. Good afternoon, sunny day outside. And yeah, I'm a little bit longer in these IT area for almost four decades right now, working as a consultant, speaker, podcaster, workshop, trainer, whatever. Started with a Commodore 64 and now working with high-end artificial intelligence. I'm a podcaster. I podcasted for 20 years right now with the SharePoint podcast. It's one of the first podcasts ever in German. And a Microsoft MVP for 26 years. And you see here in my, SharePoint MVP was my second job. The first one was front page MVP. And yeah, now I'm MVP for Copilot. So always adapting to the technologies, what's interesting me, and helping the community and share my things. So my current podcast is a Your Copilot podcast. It's running for 1.5 years. And it's my mission to help people to understand what AI and Microsoft 365 can do for them and how they can use it productively. So that's my mission with that one. And yeah, and this is something where my contribution to the SharePoint hackathon was partly. I'm not a programmer. I know something about programming, but I'm not a programmer. And so as the SharePoint hackathon, as an old SharePoint, I built up the whole SharePoint community for 21 years and said, okay, might be a good thing in connection with Microsoft 365 and the new SharePoint agent. It might be a good idea to share my experience with that one. And for me, it's always interesting to look under the hood and to know and understand how things are working. And when ChatGPT came online, end of 2022, I was really fascinating because this was the fulfillment of our dreams 30 or 40 years ago when we hacked on our C64, whatever. But on the other hand, it was also really scary, another topic to discuss. But I really wanted to know how it works. And maybe this is my metaphor picture here. I always like to pray. It's the old Volkswagen Käfer from Germany. So this small one are here. And when you look at this picture, see, oh, this guy has some problems with his car. And definitely it's a meme. It has two errors in there. First of all, the Volkswagen Käfer Beetle never was water-cooled, it was air-cooled, so the steam doesn't make sense. And when you open up the front page, you wouldn't find the engine because the engine was in the back. So, but if you open up it and you see, that's what's under the hood, and now I understand it. And so this is the metaphor for that. What when I'm looking at this slide, Microsoft presenting the Microsoft Copilot, I said, oh, that looks great. How does it work? I really wonder. Yeah, we have a large language model. It must be magic. And so what do you want to learn more? And from the day one, when I worked with ChatGPT from 2020, I really wanted to know more about how are these models built? How are the trains? How are they working? What can I learn? And I found out that relatively easily you can follow scientific papers, because the AI community is publishing, the science community is publishing papers, tons of papers each month or whatever. And so I started to look into the papers, and let me see, maybe in this paper here, this is from the Euro LLM, a multi-language language large language models for Europe. It's a special large language model focused on the 26 different languages in German in Europe. And well, this is a paper and they published it. And you know, for me as a non-scientific person, when I read here the first pages, okay, I can see that. But when you dig deeper into this one, I have no idea what this means. Isn't there someone or somebody who's can explain it to me? And maybe it would be great. It would look that one that I get from this paper, maybe a Word document that said, okay, this is a problem. This was a research team. This is a topic that was discussed. This is a methodology, the key results, top findings, and so on. And up to a summary for my podcast that can use maybe with 11 labs with a voice or whatever. So this was the challenge, or is a challenge for me. And I started this with ChatGPT relatively as soon as ChatGPT was able to process PDFs. I downloaded these papers from archive, and then I created prompts and a GPT for me, which says, okay, this is a paper, but now I want a paper for me in my language, so that can I understand, define the goal, the problem, the methods, the findings, the limitations, and boom. And this works pretty well for me. I think over the last 2 years, I have maybe 300-350 different papers downloaded and processed that with that kind of work. And it really helps me to understand what is a language model, what is fine-tuning, what is RAG, how does it do, what is a 1.58-bit model, how can I run models on my local Mac and create everything completely independent from the cloud and whatever. It was a really great and helps me really to understand it. So one of my loveliest use cases for AI and ChatGPT. And then, but this was always outside from Microsoft 365, because I couldn't do that in Microsoft 365. Also, I couldn't do it with Microsoft Copilot in the first years. But then in December, last year, Microsoft announced that it's the Copilot agent for SharePoint, and he can dig into document libraries, and you can work with documents and documents libraries. And I always remember Jeff Tepper when he told us that 2 billion of documents are uploaded into SharePoint every single day. And I said, well, yes, and that SharePoint guy, I can use SharePoint. And not only for my use case, but for every company, everyone who's using Microsoft 365 has, I think, a tremendous wealth of knowledge in the documents stored in SharePoint in the Microsoft 365 environment. And it would be a great idea if the Copilot agents can help me to dig into these sources and really get knowledge. Maybe I have a project team with a SharePoint library where they have stored the documents from 20 last projects, and now we have project number 21 and we have three problems, and we can ask, hey, here are three problems with the new project. Can we, Copilot, can you look into the other 20 projects, is there a solution or is something similar happening? And this is now possible if, as a Copilot, can look into SharePoint. So, and now for me, but so I say, okay, use the SharePoint library, put the papers in there, and build a reusable agent. And for me, it was very important. And so we can just jump in the demo. For me, it was very important. I want to do it from the end user perspective, not from nerdies or whatever. So just from the end user who has Copilot 365. Now he says, oh, you can do this with SharePoint. You can do this with your agent. And no code, no Copilot Studio. Just what can I do from scratch with only the minimum of tools that I have. And so, yeah, we can create agents. And so I set up my SharePoint library. Here's my agent folder. And there are all the documents I have stored, the PDF files. Here's the ULM file. So in there. So, and then I created an agent. And this is something what everyone can do. Mark the folder just to see it. Then click here on the three points. And then erstellen Sie an agent. It's a German service, sorry. But here's number, create an agent. You click here and then you can start to build an agent. I will jump in a second in my agent, so we won't do that. So I created an agent, and this is my hackathon paper agent here. So let's start the hackathon paper agent. And he asked me, this is an agent helping you to understand technical papers from archive.org and other resources by extracting, presenting content in a way even a non-scientific user can understand. Okay, I click on the first command here, and here I said, okay, Euro LLM. Oh, sorry, my keyboard wasn't fast. And I want to know more about the paper of the Euro LLM. And then the process started. SharePoint Copilot agent grabs the PDF and starts to build the output for me, completely understandable for me. I have worked two or three weeks until this really, from my experience, was fixed. The instructions there that can generate it, and you see, this is very good. And now when I'm here and want to get something more, I see, oh, here Euro LM1B and instruct, they have two models. Okay, let's see if it can help me more. And I ask him, hi, I will to create a chatbot for my European customers. Which of this model should I use, and please explain why? And I send up, and you see I'm talking to my Copilot right now. It's most exciting feature there. And now I get an answer. I said, okay, there are two models. Model one is the base model. It's complete, it's for text generation, translation, and comparison. Instruct model is specially for chatbot needs. And here's the recommendation, what I can do. And within seconds, I have from a scientific paper, a question in my language, understandable for my problem. So, and how is it done? It's very simple. We click in the agent edit. And so we see how the agent is constructed. Title, logo, description, the sources. And that's the cool stuff of the agent. It only looks into the resources I give him here. And on the behavior, this is in my opinion, the most important page, and it's put on the last field, is that one here, the instructions for the agent. And when you look into here, normally when you create an agent, there's a be a helpful agent and answer in a quite sophisticated way or whatever. But here I put in a real elaborated, for my purpose, elaborated prompt or instructions. You are a highly qualified technical skills specialist. You specialized in translating scientific paper into precise and comprehensive instruction. Even a layperson with an interest in science can understand, and so on and so on. And here's a whole structure with some additional informations. Yeah, and that's all. And boom, that is the result of it. And so for me, this is perfect. And I have created lots of agents here in my SharePoint libraries for different purposes. And as you can see here, tons of agents working with video transcripts, with special output formats, and it works pretty well. And I know I don't have to skip to dig into Copilot Studio or whatever. This is something every user of Microsoft 365 can do. And so this is not rocket science, and it's very easy. So, and I will show you how I find out that the instruction that we just saw, the instruction is the most important thing to define, because when the agents came up for the first time, Microsoft published this prompt coach, the writing coach, the idea coach, the career coach. And I said, okay, I tried it out. And then I find out, I don't know how I find it out, that there is a GitHub repository from the PNP community. the Copilot Pro devs examples. And in the sample file, there is lots of samples about, I'm not really sure what about it, but there was, a learning coach, and here's a writing coach. Let's look into that. When I open it up, and you see there's an app package, and when you click something, there's a declarative, there's a JSON file, and it's talking this and that one. Maybe I should say that the agent itself is based on an agent and a JSON file. And so I looked into the JSON file and said, let's see what's happening. And so go back here and say, the instruction might be a very important stuff. I clicked here and said, here is the knowledge, or not the knowledge, but here are the instructions for the learning coach Microsoft is providing. And when I put some kind of instruction in my agent, then it can behave like I want. So this is just looking under the hood. I have really no really idea how I can use everything here, but I could figure out my Copilot agent is running here for very with own cap. Let me see. And if you dig deeper, you see here in the definition, it's GPT definition called in the JSON file. And this is, when you look under the hood, it's what we have in ChatGPT for, I think, 1.5 years, GPTs. And this is based on that one. Very cool. So, and that's all. But this is something, I think I wouldn't compare with all the cool other contribution to the SharePoint hackathon, because I think this is phenomenal what you can do with that one. But this is something that everyone who has a Microsoft 365 Copilot subscription can really do now, and can dig into his own documents in the company and find out how you can profit from the knowledge in these documents. And that's it. And so that's my learning journey. And it's very cool that I can now use SharePoint. And with Researcher and whatever things, then it gets to the next level.